Hey everyone, this is Mark Ryan coming at you with another video, and today we're talking about Coca-Cola and culture. But down in the comments below, take a moment, tell me whether you are a Coke person or a Pepsi person. I rarely drink pop, if ever, but I'm a Coke person. If I get a pop, it's Coke or it's a root beer float, those two things. Now, in case you missed it, Coca-Cola is training their employees to be less white. What's going on here? And they came out with, you know, some images, some receipts saying, hey, this is what they're teaching their employees. And that's, it looks like this is what's going on there because they've gone woke. Really, the training is critical race theory is what it is. And Vodi Balcom, he'll talk about it. It is influencing people who are in your robes, which would be your pastors, are being impacted by this. Your politicians, your professors, and your judges. And so eventually it's going to affect law here in America, and it'll change it not to a biblical worldview of what law and justice is. It'll change it more to a Marxist worldview. And it's not just infecting those areas now, it's affecting our businesses, the biggest businesses that we have, Coca-Cola. A lot of businesses are falling to critical race theory, and they are doing these ridiculous trainings. And so we're going to take a look at what they're teaching, indoctrinating their employees with, and why as Christians, hey, why do we need to reject this? And so let's get started. Now let's look at some of the things that looks like we're coming out of the Coca-Cola training. And it's a big deal because this is a big company and they're indoctrinating their employees to believe these things. And it's not a Christian worldview. It's a worldview that is at war with Christianity. And so it'll say, hey, to be less white, which everyone needs to be less white, it's to be less oppressive. And how is that critical race theory, or CRT is what it's called? Well, in this worldview, you're either an oppressor or the oppressed. White people, they're the oppressors, and people of color, they're the oppressed. And so this training is critical race theory. Hey, you need to be less arrogant. Well, white people, they're the arrogant ones who've been oppressing people for a long time. And so now they need to be more humble. And you hear things like that, and they need to listen and believe others in their stories. And Christians and pastors will hear this kind of stuff, and they'll say, well, amen, those are really good things. And they try to take critical race theory and just sprinkle some Bible verses into it because it sounds really good, and then call it good. But you can't do that. I saw a quote by Charles Spurgeon today, and it was saying, hey, discernment is knowing not right from wrong so much as knowing right to almost right. And that's the problem with critical theory, is that it's almost right. It sounds really good when you hear it. It sounds very compelling when you hear it, but it's wrong. It's not the truth. First of all, God determines what right and wrong is. The founders of critical race theory, the fathers of it, the people that developed it, they did not have a Christian worldview. They did not believe that God determines what right and wrong is. They believe that they could mold and determine what right and wrong is, and they do it through this lens of turning everyone into groups and everyone into either the oppressed or the oppressors. And the next thing is, hey, you white people need to be less certain about things. And hey, by the way, do you hear the hiss of Satan there? Because as critical race theory is applied to more and more things, like critical gender theory and other theories out there, it'll say that the Christians are the oppressors, and Christians, you need to be less certain about things as well. If you're a Bible-believing Christian, you believe in sexual morality, that God determines right and wrong when it comes to morality, on how we are to live our lives. And so they're going to say, hey, you need to be less certain there. And as a Christian, we need to say, hey, no, that's the hiss of Satan trying to deceive us. When it comes to the Word of God, the Word of God is true, and it is forever right, and what is forever right will be forever right. What is wrong will always be wrong. The Word of God does not change, and we can be certain. When the Bible says something, we can be certain about it. When it comes to morality, God has spoken on those things. We can be certain about it. And critical race theory does not have a Christian worldview. It does not say that God determines what right and wrong is. They say that they determine what right and wrong is, and they break everything down into the oppressed and the oppressors. Hey, if you're a Christian and you're saying, nope, God determines whether you're male or female, you're an oppressor, you're shoving your Christianity down people's throat, and hey, you need to be less certain about your convictions there. If we apply critical race theory to other areas of critical theory, like critical gender theory, and hey, you need to stop oppressing these other people with your views. Be less certain about what God says. Be less defensive. You need to be open, more open into these things. And so for Christians, we're not open into other people defining what right and wrong is. And then he'll go on to say, hey, you know, you white oppressive people need to break with apathy and understand the worldview isn't the Christian worldview when it comes there, because if you're a Christian, it is a sin to be apathetic. Like, God commands us not to be apathetic. If we see our neighbor and there's injustice, there should be this holy, righteous anger that stirs up within us. If someone drives by an abortion clinic and doesn't get angry, there isn't this sense of anger there, there's apathy, then that's a problem for a Christian. If there were slavery going on today and Christians saw it and was like, no big deal, that's a problem. That's not okay. But the problem with critical race theory is that they define what apathy is and where you need to have that apathy. And so when it comes to abortion, your critical race theorists are going to say, yeah, you can be apathetic there. They will say that, or you can even celebrate it there. That's what your proponents of critical race theory will say. But these other things, these other areas of morality that we define, not God, but what we define, you can't be apathetic there. And so again, why should Christians reject critical race theory? Because they believe that they determine what truth is, what right and wrong is, and that God doesn't. Because all truth is God's truth. And so they see injustice. And as Christians, when we see racial injustice or whatever, we cannot be apathetic. And yet, hey, as Christians, it's because God says so, not because critical race theory says so. And so now what we're seeing in our churches, our Bible colleges, a lot of pastors, they're saying that we can take in CRT, we'll sprinkle some Bible verses on it, and it's a neutral tool that we can use. And I could not disagree any more with that. And what they'll say is, hey, we'll just sprinkle some Bible verses on it and then we'll use it. We'll integrate it into what we use. And so now it's not just scripture that speaks onto morality and defines what right and wrong is, good and evil is. Well, now it's critical race theory too. As Christian, we can't be an integrationist there. It's scripture and scripture alone that determines good and evil, and any other people that say, no, we're going to do it. As Christians, we have to reject that. And the founders of critical race theory, many of them did not believe in a creator. Overwhelmingly, they did not have a Christian worldview in many, many areas. Once you decide that there is no creator and you do away with the creator, your worldview is so twisted and so perverted and corrupt that it bleeds everywhere. No, I'm one of those people that believe critical race theory is cultural Marxism. Marxism puts the rich against the poor. Critical race theory puts white people against black people. It's destructive. With Marxism, you have people just fighting against each other all the time, nonstop. It destroys countries. It destroys cultures. And that's another reason that we can tell that it's not of God. The things that are of God aren't destructive like that. They bring life. They bring flourishing. Critical race theory is not capable of bringing life and flourishing because it perverts God's word. It perverts truth. It perverts justice. There's a lot of people within critical race theory who would say, you know what? I'm black. I'm of the oppressed group. I cannot be a racist because I am the oppressed group. In reality, God determines what racism is. It's the sin of partiality, or even hatred of another person based on their skin color or ethnicity. And God determines that. No one else can determine right from wrong. And so I'm hearing more and more people right now, Christians especially, that are saying, you know, Mark, we really need to bring in critical race theory. It's a neutral tool, and we should do it out of love for neighbor. And they're embracing that whole wrong ideology because, hey, we need to love our neighbor. Well, my response to that is, hey, if you really care about justice, go study the attributes of God. God is just. God determines what justice is. Critical race theory and their perversion of justice created by people that don't know God, that theologically they hate God, they're at war with God. They don't determine what justice is. Why would you go to the dead, the spiritually dead, to understand what justice is? I don't get that. I will never understand that. Go to God's word. Go to an elder in the faith. Learn what justice is. God is just. Study that and then apply it. And hey, God, when God sees atrocities, he's angry towards it. He has a hatred towards sin. And he's angry with the wicked every single day. When God sees someone hurt their neighbor, harm that neighbor, there's wrath that boils in him. And study that, learn that. And that'll bring out more good than critical race theory, because it's not rounded, it's not rooted in Christ or in the things of God at all, because the founders, the fathers of it, they weren't either. Hey, Mark, I really care about just what truth is nowadays, where we see so much assault on truth. Well, don't turn to critical race theory for truth. Turn to God. God is truth. That's an attribute of God. Go to God's word. Read what truth is in his word. Critical race theory, it perverts what truth is. You have to know that. You have to understand that. It's not just some neutral tool. It's soaked in a worldview. It perverts what truth is. It perverts what justice is. And we shouldn't be turning to those things. We should be turning to God and his word. God is the determiner of all things. That means God determines what truth is. God determines what justice is. And so we can be certain about those things. And that's another bad worldview that we can see that comes out of critical race theory, where it says, no, you can't be certain about these things because you Christian white male people, patriarchal people, you just use it to oppress people, shove your Christianity down people's throats. Whereas, hey, if you believe that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, the life, no one comes to the Father except through him, and all their ways they head to destruction. What we're going to see is, hey, Christians, you are oppressors. We're going to see that in the future too. But that is my thoughts on the matter. Are maybe you would say, hey, Mark, I'm never drinking a Coke again. I'm not one of those people. I'm not into cancel culture. Maybe I'll drink it less or something. Maybe I'll just drink milkshakes more. But that's just me. One of the big reasons why I started the channel was to talk about critical race theory. I saw the riots like everyone else did, burning down Minneapolis, you know, all the unrest and everything. And I became overwhelmed with the desire to just speak into it. And my conclusion is people need to know the attributes of God and throw critical race theory in the garbage. And you're seeing so many Christians who do not know who God is, do not know the attributes of God, and that's why they're embracing critical race theory. Can Christians just sprinkle a few Bible verses on this worldview and call it clean? No, you can't. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. Hey, Mark, it sounds like maybe you don't like this critical race theory stuff or something. No, I'm not a fan, actually. Yeah, in the comments below, let me know. Are you a Coke person or a Pepsi person? Maybe you're something in between. I'm more of a coffee person, actually. And then beyond that, are you into just cancel culture? Are you never going to drink a Coca-Cola ever again because they did this, and how dare they? I'm not into that. Maybe other people are. Maybe I'll drink it a little bit less. But that's just me. And I will see you in the next video.